And really, Warren, it's been a hit not just for SolarEdge, but it's been a hit for Sunrun, you know, a major residential installer. It's been a hit for Enphase. It's been a hit for SunPower. And a lot of these companies, I checked this morning, SolarEdge and Enphase are both down about 70% in the last year.
Yeah.
So it's a significant hit.
All right. Welcome to In the Loop with Larry, our November edition, where we're going to talk about a couple pieces in the news that are worthy of talking about. One, just the general direction of what we're seeing in the marketplace. Both of them, actually, on what's happening in the marketplace. So why don't we start off, Larry? And you know, they call it the solar coaster for a reason. It's up and it's down. It's sideways sometimes. It's thrilling and exhilarating. It's scary and frightening. And the last couple of years have been no exception to that. And now we're seeing the role of the solar coaster somewhat turn in a different direction. So let's talk about this first article here that was on CNBC last week, November 1st, that SolarEdge shares sink after the company offers weak Q4 guidance.
Yeah, this is hot off the press, Warren. And to your point, you know, in the last year and a half, we've had all the emotions because the IRA bill came, everyone's excited, everyone's investing in solar manufacturing, you know, the supply chain's clearing up, this is great. And now you have this big hit with SolarEdge, where they are now, I think the key part of the article there, Warren, is where it mentions that for the current quarter, SolarEdge said it expects revenue between $300 million and $350 million, missing analysts' estimate of $688 million. That's huge. That's a significant downgrade. That's about 50% of expectations. And so when investors see that, you know, they're going to start selling shares.
Sure.
Now, why all that is, it's mentioned here in the article, there's some significant headwinds, especially in the residential space. And one thing I'll just mention that it also mentioned in this article is that there isn't any concerns that I've heard of. You know, SolarEdge is located, it's based in Israel, but there's no concerns with the war at this point. So I just wanted to highlight that. As far as I know, none of these drops in the value of their stock is related to that, but rather it's more to the headwinds that you'll see there on one of those lower paragraphs. Significant headwinds. First of all, California voted to cut their compensation for residential projects. And then secondly, you have high interest rates. And those two things are really a major challenge for US installations. Now, California only affects California, but California is a big part of the residential market in the US, massive, the biggest state in the residential landscape in the US. So that was a huge hit. And then the other thing that they mentioned as well is that SolarEdge has a lot of product in distribution channel. So what happened with a company like us, there were a lot of shortages. We pre-purchased a lot of product. Well, in the last 6 months or so, we purchased a lot less product because we were using inventory. And everyone was doing that across the supply chain. Distributors were using up inventory. We were using up inventory, installers. And particularly in Europe, where a year ago they were concerned about the really high energy costs because of the war in Ukraine. And so they were purchasing, you know, every solar module and inverter they get their hands on. And now a lot of that equipment's come in, and the market's dropped lower at the same time in Europe. So SolarEdge has had a kind of a triple whammy. They have a lot of product in the channel. They have high interest rates across the board, and then the hit in California. And really, Warren, it's been a hit not just for SolarEdge, but it's been a hit for Sunrun, you know, a major residential installer. It's been a hit for Enphase. It's been a hit for SunPower. And a lot of these companies, I checked this morning, SolarEdge and Enphase are both down about 70% in the last year.
Yeah.
So it's a significant hit.
So with the reduction and the slowing in demand that we're seeing and the increase in supply, do you anticipate pricing to come down?
It's a good question. I mean, that's anyone's guess. I saw recently Enphase is saying that they feel like they're positioned well enough in the market that they won't have to reduce pricing. SolarEdge, I think, is feeling the same way. You know, what's actually going to happen? I think pricing is probably going to come down a bit. I think that's kind of the natural progression. But I will say this, both Enphase and SolarEdge have had phenomenal years the last couple of years, and they are both well positioned to handle this challenge and to come out, you know, flying high once we get through this. You know, and it could take a year, it could take a couple of years to kind of get through this slowdown.
And I think this is true not just for solar manufacturer companies, but for installers or for any business for that matter. If you've managed your business well coming into a slowdown, those are the ones that are going to thrive, and we'll probably see some consolidation coming up in the next couple of years.
Yes, most certainly there's probably going to be consolidation on the manufacturer side. I think we're going to start seeing that on the installer side, and you know, we're starting to see that on in the financing side as well.
Yeah. So we talked about the impact that interest rates would have on that have had on this residential market and the commercial markets as well. That is a good segue into our next article of discussion that was put up by Solar Power World, that Sunlight Financial announces an acquisition and files for bankruptcy. And this was at the end of the month, last week as well.
Yeah. So when I first saw this come through, Warren, that really made me nervous because Sunlight's a massive financing company. They're large. They service a lot of customers. And you know, the concern is, hey, if they file for bankruptcy, what happens to all the projects that are under development? You know, how do they get funded? What happens to the installers that aren't paid? What happens to the manufacturers that have product that's going to be installed? So that was very concerning. Fortunately, as you see in this article, there's a number of companies that have come together, Greenbacker Capital, Sunstone Credit, IGS Ventures, others as well, that have come together to buy out Sunlight and keep the company going. And I think what they're going to need is probably an infusion of cash to keep them going and hopefully get them moving back in the right direction.
Yeah, really illustrates just some of the challenges that high interest rates have on the industry as a whole.
Absolutely. You know, and I think that's one of the things that I want to highlight here is I'm not concerned about the residential industry. I'm not concerned about the industry as a whole. I think it's going to bounce back pretty quickly. The residential industry is going to take more time because it's more tied into interest rates. The California issue, tied into net metering challenges. And also there's just so much product in the channel and so many challenges. When you go from high demand to low demand that quickly, there's going to be a lot of challenges, a lot of ripple effects, but it will hit some companies. There's going to be companies that go out of business, and there's going to be some consolidation. I do also want to highlight here at a little bit farther down there in the article where they note there that, you know, all their channel partners, contractors, installers, everyone's going to be paid in full. Their employees are going to keep getting paychecks. You know, they're going to keep trying to do business as usual as much as possible, which is really nice to see. And I think it also highlights, Warren, that investors do see the industry pulling out of this, or they wouldn't, you know, invest in a company like Sunlight.
Right.
So they do see a bright future, but there's certainly headwinds and challenges in the present.
Yep. Back to the solar coaster. Everything has its cycles, its ups and its downs, and there's no doubt that the residential market will pull back.
Yep. And the key thing that I would just say to people thinking about going solar is make sure that you're working with companies, manufacturers, installers, financing companies that are strong, that have been successful, that have been profitable, and you should be fine. These companies are the ones that are going to make it through.
Absolutely. Great advice. Great point there. Excellent. Well, thank you, Larry. That was very insightful. Appreciate it. And we'll see you next month.
Thanks, Warren.
Thanks.